probably mock interview without a mock position. No matter what kind of job you try to get in the future, it all comes down to knowing exactly how to market yourself. And this game show teaches you just that. Plus, it is extremely valuable to hear different people to share their stories and perspectives.
Tonight, we will have 8 student candidates with very different backgrounds coming on stage, one after another, to impress our 8 judges. And they hope that their performance can be so impressive that the judges will be willing to spend the money and the time to buy the students dinners in spite of their very busy schedules.
Each judge will have one light in front of them. The lights remain on as long as they still want to buy the students dinners. And they can turn the lights off when they don't want it anymore. And they have 2 Christmas trees representing 2 offers to 2 different students. And the Christmas trees, when the Christmas trees are given away, they will no longer be able to make any offers.
So first, each candidate will give a very brief self-introduction. Then we will play the video that we recorded during the first round of interviews. And lastly, the candidates will answer questions from us and the judges.
If there are 2 judges fighting to buy the student dinner, then the student gets to ask the 2 a question and decides which offer to take. If there are more than 2 judges still in the game, then the student has to choose which 2 judges to ask questions to. Without further ado,
let's see who our judges are. Let's y'all give a huge round of applause. Cool. All right, let's give a huge round of applause for everybody. Thank you very much for coming out today. So first off, we will begin with our very first contestant. Her name is Cindy Liu. So Cindy, if you can please come up and give a brief introduction of yourself.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Cindy. Currently, I have 3 occupations with me. Firstly, I'm definitely a student in Berkeley, where it offers me so many opportunities, for example, if you are the one. Secondly, I'm an MUNer, because I promised myself to, after high school graduation, that I want to carry on the MUN philosophy, which is to negotiate with other people, or maintain my own principle, and to understand other people from their perspectives. Lastly, I'm a dancer, a job that I gained just this semester. In Berkeley Ballroom Dancing Team, I gradually learned how to be a good follower after 18 years of emphasis on how to be a good student leader. I believe learning how to follow will eventually prepare me to lead better in life. In the future, I hope I can be a businesswoman because I want to help all those people in need with all my resources. I'm really looking forward to listening to the advice today and afterwards. Thank you very much for your attention.
Okay, so now we're going to take a look at a video. Thank you, Cindy. So you have worked very hard compared to a lot of your peers, and you have participated in a business plan competition, you led research on the trade relationships between China and America, and you also organized charity concerts for blind children. What motivates you to do all of this?
To most of you, and it sounds a little bit non-ambitious, but it's actually very important to me. I remember once my mom told me to maintain myself in the first half, no matter which community you are in. And that is actually the first motivation I gained and to support myself. And after a while, I suddenly realized that if I take this as the sole motivation to move forward, there is always an end. Because of the limitation of the community. And even if I am the first one in the community, I still need a kind of motivation to support myself to move forward. So I kind of changed my role from myself to my mom and tried to motivate other people to change a little bit in their life. And I feel like it's a very amazing thing to think of that when other people think of you, they will think that, okay, Cindy influenced my life a little bit. So I really hope that I can change other people's life, you know, not only the academic performance of my classmates, but also people in a more broader scale. For example, like all around the world, and I can better off their life with my interest of business, and that is basically how I motivate myself to move forward. Thank you very much.
Now is the time for the judges to ask questions about Cindy. Anyone?
All right, let me take the lead to start. So, I try not to be mean, but sometimes. Oh, I have lights, but I don't have one. So the first question is that you mentioned you want to change people's life. On the other hand, you want to do business, right? Sometimes it's a little conflicting to me because business is making profit. Change people's life in a good way, charitable, sometimes doesn't fit with the concept of doing business. If I'm the owner of the business, you told me that you want to be philanthropy. Maybe you meet the right folks. But sometimes I'm doing the startup. I want you to just make profit. I don't care your goal, how do you respond?
Okay, I learned from modeling educations that the society is very unbalanced anyway, and the roles in the society is not totally fair to me. And actually, I don't really sure if I want to start my own business or not. And probably I just like you said, I probably gonna work for some other people. If that's the case, I'm probably gonna work for a non-profit organization. And in that process itself, it's already a kind of helping other people. But if I'm going to start my own business, I really hope that my company can gather the profit from the society and distribute to those people who really need it. It's a kind of try to balance out the world of the society.
Cindy, I think I heard that your goal is try to help people. But can you be more specific for next 5 to 10 years? What's your specific career goal to achieve?
Okay. For the first few years of my career life, I'm currently thinking about consulting. Like I've communicated with some of you guys, and because I feel like by consulting, I can travel around the world and know more people. And I really like how Steven told me that consulting is about a lifestyle. And I feel like that lifestyle will help me to do a lot of networking and to know more people and to really understand different industries that I want to really dig into in the future. And that is the kind of prep stage of my career goal. So I will probably take consulting as my first stage of career and try to know more information and learn very fast in this industry. Thank you.
Cool. All right, thank you very much, Cindy. Now if we can have the panel, did we have one more question?
I also have one more question. So probably I'm the last guy asking.
Okay.
So the question is the best part of myself?
Yeah.
I think the best or the most confident part of myself is to find the solutions. And I that means that I don't know everything for sure as a freshman. And I think it's really important to find how to solve a problem in a way that in this case you can understand more about what you don't know and try to make yourself more knowledgeable. And I think this is also a very important quality for consulting industries, because for that industry, you have to be able to solve problems in a comparatively very short time and to learn very fast about the company and the industry in very short days. So in this case, I feel like solving a problem and understanding how to solve a problem in general is very important. Thank you.
Now the Q&A section between the judges and the contestant is over. Now is the time for the judges to offer some comments.
And also for the lights, you can, during the entire session, if you find any of the responses not really hitting what you are going for, you can also turn off your light. But right now is, if you have any comments or any feedback for Cindy, this would be the time to do that now.
So I first comment. So if you really be careful about life, then really I want to ask you two or three sentences, and you overthink too much. So, very important, because we want to impress the interviewer really very precisely and concisely. And also, if you talk too much, people get confused and get lost.
That's
very important.
Thank you so much for the advice.